You're kicking it with JLee TV Live. Please stay tuned while we prepare to start our show. Be sure to share this podcast for your chance to enter into our random prize giveaways right here on JLee TV Live. Kicking it with JLee TV Live. Please stay tuned while we prepare to start our show. Be sure to share this podcast for your chance to enter into our random prize giveaways right here on JLee TV Live. Kicking it with JLee TV Live. Please stay tuned while we prepare to start our show. Be sure to share this podcast for your chance to enter into our random prize giveaways right here on JLee TV Live. You're kicking it with JLee TV Live. Please stay tuned while we prepare to start our show. Be sure to share this podcast for your chance to enter into our random prize giveaways right here on JLee TV Live.
You're kicking it live with JLee TV, the hottest channel for entertainment, world news, information on local black businesses, as well as financial literacy topics right here on your favorite podcast. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for chances to receive giveaways, as well as stay tuned for all of our Showtime alerts right here on JLee TV.
Welcome in, welcome in. We was having some technical difficulties, y'all, excuse me. But you guys are live with JLee TV Live. Had to get my sound right. So y'all bear with me. But on today's show, this is episode 2 of JLee TV Live. We're talking about facts you didn't know about slavery. So you guys came to the right show. If y'all don't know what JLee TV Live is, JLee TV Live is the newest podcast to social media that gives a voice to a lot of topics we feel matter to you most. And this platform allows other businesses, entrepreneurs, and community public figures a chance to be heard while discussing world news and what's happening now. So come on in, show some love, and let's keep down on negative energies. Now, moving forward, the title of our show, if you guys have not seen right there in the description, is Facts You Didn't Know About Slavery. It is Black History Month, and we are dedicating this second episode of our show to the lost ancestors of the African-American community who paved the way for Blacks and so many Americans today. Now, we will be talking about how slavery has been affected in the African-American community during and after slavery. Has slavery affected how we see the world today through dance, food, music, and technology? We see a lot of our works in everything we see today. So make sure you guys stay tuned and find out as we dig deeper into the discussion as we go. We have a wonderful show for you today. So definitely adjust your seats for this. Warning to all the viewers watching this, viewer discretion is advised. If you have children or youth watching, please make sure that you guys cover their eyes or you monitor what they're watching. I will be discussing a lot of stuff that may be offensive to a lot of people or make some people feel uncomfortable. This is merely for educational purposes only. So being said, you have the chance to turn away right now. You can leave. Okay. If not, if you're still here, and if you're not here yet, you guys just better know. Watching this pre-recording is about to go down because I'm about to talk about some real stuff. So I want to give a shout out to all my partner sponsors. And to give update, we are still currently working on our website. We are working on making our platform better for all of you in hopes to give our audience a better experience. So you guys just got to be patient. We will be able to send, you will be able to send requests about stuff that you guys want me to talk about on my show. You will be able to stay updated to our JLee TV news alerts, as well as get a chance to watch all our missed media. So if you miss any of the shows, you can go to the website real soon and just watch it on there, download it, however you please. And I also want to send out a special thank you to all of our viewers tuning in live right now and the ones that's going to come later in the pre-recording. So let's get into today's show. But before we do, we're going to go to a quick break and start our discussion when we return. So please share this live while you can until we come back. You guys make sure you stay tuned. This is a tribute to Black History Month right here on JLee TV Live.
When the sun comes back, when the first quail calls, follow the dragon gold. For the old man is waiting for, carry you to freedom, follow the dragon gold. Well, a riverbank is a mighty good road, dead trees show you.
Welcome back to the JLee TV Live show. I'm your host, Wayne Frelot, if you didn't know. And today's tribute is to Black History Month. If you guys didn't catch the title, make sure you guys share, subscribe, follow to the movement. If you haven't yet, but diving right in, growing up as a youth, it took me till I actually moved to Mississippi as a youth. A lot of people don't know that before I moved to Louisiana, which was majority of my upbringing, I lived in Mississippi, a small town of Port Gibson, right there near Vicksburg. And it took me till then till I started learning about slavery, because I was, you know, raised up northwest area of the United States. So I didn't have a lot of culture about the South. And I can remember going to the Vicksburg Museum and seeing the site where they had the Battle of Vicksburg. It was crazy. They had the Confederate money, like the duplicate money you can get. You could trade into your money for that as a kid. And then I witnessed, they had like a little haunted house where they hung the slaves, and it was really haunted, like for real. Like you could feel just something weird about the house. But they have these memorials and they had these things. And I didn't really understand what slavery really was and what blacks really went through in this country. So today we're going to talk about some of that stuff. And we're going to talk about who those Africans really were and what they endured here. But first thing we got to ask to understand slavery is, where did it start? How did it get here to America and why? Most who have no history of slavery and African heritage usually feel that, based on textbooks anyway, that we came on a slave boat, were beat and forced to pick cotton. That's about it. Yet blacks have a far, far more beautiful, beautiful history and royal history than people really know. So we will talk about that on another topic. But today we're going to dive right in and just talk about what happened right here on American lands. OK, and like I said in the title today, we're going to talk about facts that people didn't know about slavery. OK. And the first fact that I thought was real interesting that I posted, and I did a few of them, but the first fact that I got is about fleeing from a slave master. Back then, they considered you running from your slave master a mental disorder. So I'm crazy for running. I'm crazy for running from torture, from death, and, you know, rape and all type of stuff they was putting these Africans through. So they deemed it a disease of the mind to run away from an owner. A writing from the medical doctor Samuel Cartwright stated that he felt blacks were inferior to whites. So he felt that, hey, if you run, boy, there's something wrong with you. You know that, right? You know, a good slave is supposed to be obedient to his master. You're not supposed to be running. Something's wrong with your brain. You can't survive out there. If you think you're running, that's not right. I take care of you. I feed you. I give you water, boy. Basically, you know, a lot of psychology played into the manipulation of slavery. You know, fact two. And we're going to move forward from that. Y'all see that picture there? Okay, we're going to move forward. Fact two, Africans' economic skills seemed, by statistics, American statistics, were the leading reason for the enslavement of Africans. The way they build things, their skills in technology, crafting, food, sanitation, medicines, and all that, that's the reason that they captured the slaves. For a lot of people that don't know why they chose blacks, not just because they're melanin attributes and the God gene in them, it's because they were builders. They came from the Moorish families of Kemet, Kush, you know, things like that. And they were very skilled. And they knew that. The Europeans knew that. The Portuguese knew that, because a lot of the slaves went to the Portuguese and the Spanish. A lot of people don't know. So a lot of those slaves during American slave trade, through the slave trade movement, early as the 17th century, they were trading slaves. You know, it's crazy. So that was the main reason why they grabbed them. They said, hey, these boys can build. They know a lot of stuff. We need access to that information. And they still do it today. They take a lot of technology today. It's just what it is. But moving on to fact number three. The mortality rate among slaves were very high. Okay. So the slave masters would often encourage or force women to have children, even at the age of 13, or as soon as they show signs of menstruation. So as soon as they had a little cycle, the slave masters wanted to breed them. Okay. And women were expected to have children to replenish the slave stock. They were also expected to have 4 to 5 children by the age of 20. And they were often encouraged by the masters to do things for the for their freedom. So they would lie to them and say, hey, if you have these many kids or if you do this sexually or whatever, you just shut up and do what I tell you, I'll free you. Which a lot of times never happened. It never happened. It was crazy. Moving on to fact four, I thought was real interesting. Vicious dogs around that time that people use as pests today, even as African-Americans. These dogs were used to hunt runaway slaves and to track them down and get them. As you see right there, there's a hound of some sort. I don't know what kind it is. They usually use like foxhounds, bloodhounds, pit bulls, and things like that. Pit bulls, yes. Unfortunately, pit bulls were used in slavery, and they had very strong jaws. They can attach to the slave and, you know, really take them down really quickly. And they herded slaves together really quick. So those dogs were very smart. And it's kind of crazy that African-Americans, they bond to pit bulls more now. I don't know if it was because of the cultural things, but it is what it is. Now, I want you guys to check out this this quick clip right here. I'm about to show you guys, because during slavery, they had to really get smart, and they had to figure out a way to run from these dogs, sometimes smearing manure on themselves or different things that they thought, bear urine, whatever they can find, dead animal carcasses that they wouldn't have smell like themselves. I thought this clip was real interesting. Y'all check this out.
You have led dogs to me.
I have done nothing.
I will shoot you.
No. Look, onion, rub. Dogs cannot smell. Take it.
Look. You are mad. To hell with you.
If y'all haven't seen that movie, that's Emancipation by Will Smith. Well, not by him, but you know, he's starring in that film. You definitely got to go check that out. That's a real interesting film. But back to the facts, you know, they had vicious dogs that they were breeding. They were just making up dogs and just testing them out on Africans. Just to kind of keep them at bay, because that's very scary to have a dog just snapping at you when you wake up. You're trying to, you know, wake up and eat your breakfast and go outside and tend to your chickens, because they did have a little farm. Believe it or not, they did give slaves the opportunity to have real estate and stuff back then during slavery. So a lot of slaves did own land. So on their little land that they lived on, you know, they would have dogs at them in the morning, at night, to get them up to go collect this cotton, right? So that was that really sucked. Moving on to fact number five, guys. This was very interesting to me, because growing up in the church, I used to always see these ushers with white gloves. I used to always wonder, like, what's going on with the white gloves? What's the white gloves thing about? And I can remember the first time I seen that, the offering plate going around, and they're passing it around, and I'm looking at it like, white gloves? Like, are we dirty or something? You know, and then I did a little research, and it states, by just informative information, just passed down from generations to generations, that they had the blacks wear gloves because in the church services, they didn't want the black hands touching the skin of the white people. And also, if the slave ended up trying to steal any type of money or anything out the church, they can see their hands easier, because I guess white gloves, you just can see easier. So that's where that came from. So yes, that usher in the church that got one hand behind her back, one hand on the fan, standing on the side of the pews. Yes, that was an actual racial move that they did on black folks right there. They just didn't trust them. Put on the white gloves. Let me see your hands, basically. So white gloves had to be worn on slaves during church services, as well as you know, for reasons of just having their hands shown. So they can be easier to take it if they stole. All right. Now moving on to the next fact. Fact number six. It's crazy. This one just blows my mind because me growing up in the Louisiana area, I heard about this. I heard a lot of older men and older, you know, blacks that are age elders telling me about this. Even in school, I went to Grambling and they told me about this. And I was just like, what? There's no possible way they did this. Okay. Just how? What gets a person in their right mind to want to do something like this? Now, as you can see in the photo, there's a baby right there tied to a branch. And then you got the slave master over there shooting a gator. So children were used for bait for gators to make leather shoes, belts, hats, collect teeth, and to be used for meat. Okay. They would tie the infant baby with rope and throw the baby into the gator swamp so that it can panic and attract the gator. So the baby is crying, missing his mom, wanting milk, whatever the reason is. And it's cold out there late at night. That slave master just wants to hunt. He don't care. He don't care about the life of that African American. You know, so he just took the baby out there, as you can see in the photo, as a depiction of what they did around that time. And that's just horrible. I did hear about that growing up, and I was just like, crazy, like they really did that. I also heard that they would actually tie the rope around the baby's like arms, like all around the top of them, all the way down, and then throw the baby in the water as well and let the baby drown, kick his feet and panic and drown. It's crazy stuff that I've heard, but that's fact number six. If you didn't know, you know now. I told you guys, cautious, because it's going to be a lot of crazy stuff on this right here, you know, a lot. So you guys just be careful. If you don't want to hear this stuff, turn away. I don't take no offense, but back at it. We're going to go ahead and go to a quick break. I think that we should do that. We're going to go to a quick break because I don't have a lot today that I'm going to go over. We'll keep it real short and sweet because I got a lot of more shows that I want to do. I just feel like this is important to talk about on this Sunday, but we're going to go to a quick break, but please be sure to share this live. Please. That's all y'all got to do. I'll be doing a lot more reviews as well as educational videos later, but I need an audience to make this stuff happen. Okay. So big thanks to all the supporters and viewers who subscribe to our channel. We will be right back with the discussion when we return here on JLee TV Live. Okay. Right back.
You're tuning into JLee TV Live. This podcast is sponsored by
Look Sharp and Debonair and Brianna Belair.
Look Sharp and Debonair and Brianna Belair.
Brianna Belair specializes in men's, women's, and children's classic couture.
So look smooth.
Look suave.
Look sharp and debonair.
And Brianna Belair.
Available in fine stores everywhere.
Life. Such an organic and unpredictable gift given by the universe. Everything we are and will become all comes from the very experiences that define our future. How we protect our assets matter to the establishment of our legacy. That's why here at Global Legacy Financial, we take pride in our mission statement to dedicate quality products that secure financial stability. We offer free consultation services to help you develop a proper financial needs analysis, as well as offer many brand products to fit your financial needs. Whether you're looking for a living or death benefit, we got you covered. All of our agents are federally licensed and trained to work with you personally when you submit our easy quick survey form completed on our web. Learn how you can create a living, death, and financial plan exclusively to you. Need better medications and medical supply products? No problem. Ask about our prescription drug, Medicare supplemental, hearing, vision, and dental plans available to you when you contact one of our team of professionals. Plan ahead and allow Global Legacy Financial to assist you in creating the plan you deserve. Get the proper and affordable coverage you've always been wanting when you contact us today. Every day we're changing lives, one family at a time.
You're kicking it live with JLee TV, the hottest channel for entertainment, world news, information on local black businesses, as well as financial literacy topics right here on your favorite podcast. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for chances to receive giveaways, as well as stay tuned for all of our Showtime alerts right here on JLee TV.
Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to the show. You guys are kicking it with JLee TV Live here on YouTube. Today we are honoring Black History Month and discussing facts you didn't know about slavery and the history of slavery. All right. And we left off on fact number 7. So we're going to go ahead and pull up that screen here. Go to the next fact. This is crazy. Slave owners at that time was so bent on slavery, like they had to, like they just like believed in it so much that they began believing that slavery was grounded in the Bible. They didn't just tell slaves this, they actually believed it. And they used a different Bible to justify slavery. And it's currently used today. They still use the Bible that they recreated to justify slavery. It's known as the Holy Bible. If you look at Ephesians, chapter 6, verses 5 through 8, Paul states, slaves can be obedient. Slaves, be obedient to your human masters with fear and trembling, in sincerity of heart as to Christ, which is Paul instructing slaves to obey their masters, basically. Similar statements regarding obedient slaves can be found in Colossians chapter 3, 22 through 24, and 1 Timothy chapter 6, 1 through 2, as well as Titus chapter 2, verse 9 through 10. They have a lot of information in the Bible about slavery and slaves being obedient to their masters. So that's a fact a lot of people don't know about. Moving on to fact number 8. This is crazy right here, and I thought this was very fascinating. Some of you may know this, some of you may not, but slave women used to hide seeds, tools, food, and personal items, and anything else actually that they can keep from their slave masters in their hair. And this is what really brought out the whole swag of braids here in this country, because they were doing it way back in Africa. So as you see here, here's a couple of styles that the African queens did back then, from the Nubians to the Moroccans, to a lot of different tribes that colonized here. And then if you look over to the right, that's just an example of how they would do that. I think those are, if I'm saying it right, I hope it's Moroccans. She's getting rice braided into her hair, or seeds into her hair. I just thought that was cool to put that picture side by side so y'all can kind of see or imagine what they did in slavery with their actual hair. I thought that was pretty dope. Now, moving on to the next one. This is crazy. Fact number 9. Convict leasing. Let me say it again. Convict leasing was a big thing after the abolition of slavery, back in 1865. This ran for a few years where the slave owners were so dependent on, you know, their cookies that they didn't, which were the Negroes, the treasures, that they didn't want to pull away from that. They weren't trying to release any slave, you know, lifestyle that they were used to, getting their food cooked and stuff and prepared. They didn't want to let go of that. So the convict leasing program replaced slavery after the Civil War. Inmates could be bartered as property, serving the rest of the time as servants. Convict leasing in the United States was widespread in the South during the Reconstruction period. And after the end of the Civil War, when many Southern legislators were ruled by majority coalitions of blacks, they had actual groups that went together, like white people that were actually getting together and having a coalition that pushes, you know, against, you know, the abolition of slavery after they've been freed. So it's crazy, you know, they were, and these were like big people, like governors, mayors, people from the union and, you know, stuff like that. Now, moving forward, we're going to go to the 10th fact here. Look at this. Male slaves at the age of 15, that young, they were inspected to see if they could breed well. And if it was deemed that they could not, their testicles would be castrated. Over the course of 5 years, each young male was expected to get at least 12 female slaves pregnant. That's a lot. According to slave narratives, a male slave named Bert was said to have fathered over 200 children. And you notice back in the day, a lot of grandfathers and stuff coming into this, you know, that was in our upbringing from our fathers and stuff like that, they had a lot of kids. They had over like 40, 50 kids. Granddaddy was out there getting it. And some of it wasn't just because granddaddy wanted to have children. It was just a mindset because he was forced to have children. He was forced to breed. It was an actual thing that they did where they actually would breed the slaves. That's just what it is. Now, moving on to fact number 11. This one right here, as you can see from the picture, it basically tells you, self-explanatory, what is going on in this picture. You see a actual freed slave getting recaptured. So right after the blacks would, you know, be gone and living their life and stuff like that, they'd be mad to see an African so clean, so paid, with their land, minding their business, happy family, that they had to go recapture that slave and break his mind to put fear in other slaves. That, hey, if you leave, you're going to come back anyway, right? So that's the thing that they did. Freed slaves were kidnapped and resold into slavery whenever payments weren't paid by slaves and work or promises weren't made. This is just what they did. You know, moving on to fact number 12. During the slave trade, this is crazy. When I looked this up, I was like, there's no way that this is real. It can't be real. Out of all the information that I've researched on this right here to get this prepared for you guys, this is one of the ones that it kind of messed me up. So during the slave trade, guys, check this out. Over 30,000 enslaved African people entered the U.S. yearly. Over 30,000 a year, right? That number grew quickly, of course, due to breeding and stuff like that by slaves and the slave owners. So the slaves were making love as well as the slave owners was just pushing them to breed, pushing. Fast forward to 2005, Africans have entered the country more per year on their own than during the American slave trade. So more Africans have came here just on their own, just moving here and stuff like that. So Akon, if you're listening, oh yeah, I'm just kidding. But yeah, Africans are here now. They're like, hey, we got stolen and brought here. Why not? Why not just move here? So yes, there's more Africans here now coming into the country than it was during the slave trade. Oddly, you know, probably because there's no more beating and stuff here, but they're here. So we're going on to the next fact. This is crazy right here too. This was a one that really got me too. You know, and this is probably could be one of the causes why we have a lot of manipulation in our Black families, in our homes. Because back then during slavery and during this slave era, the slave wife could never be loyal to her husband. Got that? She couldn't even be loyal to him. That was the thing. They're like, hey, you guys are made to just work your property. You're made to breed. Forget that love stuff. Shut up. I'll pull you guys apart. So here, as you see, they got the man chained here separately, and they got the daughter chained to the mother. She's over here separately working on another side. So the slave wife would never be allowed to be loyal to their husband. And as most slave owners demanded, she had to have affairs with other men. So she had to, like, to breed and things like that. So he sees you fall in love with this woman. He might go pull this woman out, watch you watch another man have sex with your wife. It's crazy. You know, if you was the man anyway. But they actually forced him, you know, and she was also not allowed to remain pure at any point. So she couldn't even be a virgin. So it was like, no, we don't do that. We don't, ain't no virgins. Negroes, virgins, basically. So moving on to the next fact. This is wild. This is a wild one, y'all. Some slave men, okay, were purchased by their owners solely by the size of their penis. So he's looking at this guy here like, hey, boy, I'm finna show me that pecker, boy. Show me that Johnson, that Jimmy Dean, boy. You know, he's sitting there, look at you looking at that boy. Look at him, straight face, eyebrows frowned up and everything. Black dude like, bro, I'm just trying to go home, bro. I ain't got no shoes on, it's cold. You know, he ain't trying to hear all that. So they would actually check these men's penis size and see, hey, I want this one, you know, stuff like that. The slave men were often raped by their gay slave owners. They were raped, and this process was called buck breaking. So they would do that to break the mind of that male, you know, big, strong, you know, swole, you know, manly African king. They would try to break them down by buck breaking them, because that's something they just never seen and never heard of. It's like, what the hell is this? So they would rape them Black men. That's crazy. And a lot of that stuff washed into our society, you know, subconsciously. Got to understand, some of y'all's great grandfathers was raped, sadly. It trickles down and it trickles down. Sad. Well, we're moving on to the next fact here. This is fact number 15. And I think this is my last fact, I believe. American slaves in 1860 were worth $4 billion. Listen to this, y'all. Which was more than the $228 million worth of gold and silver circulating back then. So slaves were worth more than gold and silver. Way, way more. Look at these signs. One sign is for $1,200. That's a lot of money now. Now, today, that'd be millions of dollars just to buy one slave, probably. I don't know. A couple hundred thousand dollars to buy a slave. It's just crazy. So $4 billion, which was for more than $228 million worth of gold and silver circulating back then. So that's how much they were worth in 1860. All right. Even the value of Southern farmland at $1.92 billion did not amount to the worth of slaves. That's crazy. To the slave masters, their slaves were everything to them. So they didn't even want to release that. They was like, I'm not giving up my slaves over this. No, slaves are more valuable. So they were not trading any slaves. Let a slave run away and go to another plantation, or another slave owner steal their slave is up. They fight. Now, did you know that the value of 40 acres and a mule for those 40,000 free slaves would be $640 billion today? Did you know that? So that 40 acres in the mule that they promised them for just 40,000 freed slaves would be worth $640 billion today. And by 2025, they say that the black buying power here in this country is estimated to grow $1.98 trillion. That's how much money we have today alone. Just shows how many black people are here and how much money we have circulating on our own. So we got to ask this question. Based on all this stuff that's been going around, is payment on the way to blacks? Are they going to pay reparations ever? Is it going to happen? I know they've been talking about it when I was a kid. I know that in, 2021, in Evanston, Illinois, became the first U.S. city to actually create a reparations plan for its black residents, right? And then California that year set up a plan sort of like it. And I think they're leading. California is leading right now. Don't try to go move to California thinking you're going to get a check if you're black. This is something that they already have in action, that they have circulating. So it is what it is. But please let us know your opinion in the comments. Let me know what you feel would happen if they break bread with us. What do y'all think is going to happen if they break bread to blacks all over the world? If they say, you know what, each one of y'all get $350,000 a piece. Bread it. What do y'all think blacks gonna do? Are they gonna cut up? Are they gonna act right? They're gonna invest in businesses or you know, what do you think? I want to see that in the comments when I go back over the comments. I really enjoy hearing from y'all. So I appreciate all y'all that stopped by today. Definitely please let me know. We're gonna go to a quick commercial break before we go and close our show for today. Stay tuned. You guys are watching JLee TV Live. I love you guys so much. You guys are awesome. Stay tuned.
You're tuning into JLee TV Live. This podcast is sponsored by.
Look sharp and debonair and Briani Belair.
Look sharp and debonair and Briani Belair.
Briani Belair specializes in men's, women's, and children's classic couture.
So look smooth.
Look suave.
Look sharp and debonair
and Briani Belair.
Available in fine stores everywhere.
Life. Such an organic and unpredictable gift given by the universe. Everything we are and will become all comes from the very experiences that define our future. How we protect our assets matter to the establishment of our legacy. That's why here at Global Legacy Financial, we take pride in our mission statement to dedicate quality products that secure financial stability. We offer free consultation services to help you develop a proper financial needs analysis, as well as offer many brand products to fit your financial needs. Whether you're looking for a living or death benefit, we got you covered. All of our agents are federally licensed and trained to work with you personally when you submit our easy quick survey form completed on our web. Learn how you can create a living, death, and financial plan exclusively to you. Need better medications and medical supply products? No problem. Ask about our prescription drug, Medicare supplemental, hearing, vision, and dental plans available to you when you contact one of our team of professionals. Plan ahead and allow Global Legacy Financial to assist you in creating the plan you deserve. Get the proper and affordable coverage you've always been wanting when you contact us today. Every day we're changing lives, one family at a time.
You're kicking it live with JLee TV, the hottest channel for entertainment, world news, information on local black businesses, as well as financial literacy topics right here on your favorite podcast. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for chances to receive giveaways, as well as stay tuned for all of our Showtime alerts right here on JLee TV.
Welcome back. Welcome back to JLee TV Live. It's your host, Wayne Frelot, again. Y'all did great today. I don't know how I did, but I'll let you guys be the judge of that right there in the comments. We are back again discussing today facts you may not have known about slavery. You guys can replay it because that's all the facts I got for y'all today, because we're at the end of our show. I want to thank you guys for tuning into our network. And please, please, please be sure to follow, share, and subscribe to this network if you haven't. So you know when we're online, actually hit that alert button. It's like a little bell, a little YouTube bell. Just hit that thing. Ding. You'll get alerted as soon as I'm online, so I don't have to be. I missed the show or whatever. You guys stop in. This show is built for you guys, so I can create a platform for you guys to get the information you deserve. If you have a business and you want me to promote it here on my network, and you're looking for, or you're looking for a feature on my show, please feel free to email me at jleetvlive@gmail.com for more information on how to be a part of this show. I appreciate you guys stopping by. I love you guys dearly. And you guys have been watching JLee TV Live. That's the end of our show.
Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt land.
So hard they could not stand.
Let my people go.
So the Lord said, go down.
Go down,
Moses.
Moses.
Way down in Egypt land. Tell old Pharaohs to let my people go.
Let my people go.
So Moses went to Egypt land.
Let my people go.
He made old Pharaoh understand.
Let my people go.
Yes, the Lord said, go down.
Go down,
Moses.
Moses.
Way down.
Down
in Egypt land. Tell him Pharaohs to let my people go.
Let my people go.
Thus spoke the Lord, bold Moses said,
let my people go.
If not, I'll smite your firstborn dead.
Let people go.
Cause the Lord said, go down.
Go down,
Moses.
Moses.
Way down,
down
in Egypt land. Tell old Pharaoh
to let my people go.